Welcome everyone, very good morning to one and all. Thank you for joining us today for the webinar, and we look forward to having an interactive webinar with you guys and hope we learn from each other. With us today is Ms. Supriya Sharma. I would like to introduce her. Ms. Supriya Sharma is a seasoned HR professional with over 14 years of work experience gained while working with Fortune 500 companies like Oracle, GE, Adobe, Fiverr. In her last assignment, she worked as the director of HR at Fiverr. She is currently working with Xoxoday as the business development head for Australia and New Zealand region. Supriya lives in Sydney and loves to explore the sea and sand in the summers. Hi, Supriya. Welcome to the session. How are you doing today?
Hi, Shivam. I'm doing well. Thank you. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you for asking. Great.
Thanks for the great introduction.
Thank you. So let's begin with the webinar.
Sure.
Here comes the first question. So do you think there's an AI revolution that is going on right now?
Well, it definitely seems revolutionary as the pace of change in technology is becoming faster by the day. Digital intelligence is transforming the workplace. Man and machine are working closely, powered by an ever-increasing demand of data in the cloud and the use of big data and artificial intelligence to power them. So I think we see all the changes in our lives every day. We're already seeing it at workplaces, the way the roles are getting defined and they are changing by the day from how they have existed even 10 years back. I think there's been a significant change. And so like Jean-Paul Egon from L'Oreal says, digital is not the cherry on the cake, it is the new cake. Artificial intelligence is not the future. It is already happening and it is already widely available across organizations.
So how do you think that artificial intelligence can be applied in the HR function?
So artificial intelligence in HR is inevitable. Not only will it provide cost efficiency to systems, but also enable more effective decision making in HR. HR has always had huge access to employee data. And most of the times this data has resided in separate functions, for example, recruiting, talent development, or performance management. Each of them have had disintegrated parts of data. I think with the onslaught of technology as well as artificial intelligence, this data will get more integrated and HR functions will be leveraging it for effective decision making so much more and for also enhancing employee experience. I remember a time when I joined a particular organization. I wouldn't name it here, but I joined a particular organization and for accessing my employee records, I was directed to a particular system. For submitting my performance appraisal system, I was directed to another system. Mm-hmm. For reimbursing my rewards or the awards that I was allocated, I was directed to another system. So as an employee, I was a customer of 5 or 6 different systems in an organization, which clearly killed my employee experience. It clearly made it very cumbersome and very discouraging for me to go to each of these portals and do each of these actions. And as an employee with very little stake in some of these actions, I just didn't feel like sometimes even logging into this. Systems and completing those transactions. So I think AI is here to transform how HR has been operating in all these years and how employees have been experiencing HR all these years. And so, yeah, I look forward to a whole lot of change happening.
I agree with the point.
I think just to add, you know, there's already so much of research happening around this. And, you know, as per one of the research, which was published by PricewaterhouseCoopers, 40% of the HR functions of international companies are currently using artificial intelligence applications worldwide. 50% will invest in data analytics to find and develop talent and keep people engaged. Organizations, I would like to say that organizations have already been investing in data analytics in the past, but the data has been very static and very disintegrated, like I said earlier, and that's going to change. It's going to become much more seamless, and you know, the insights that come from the data are going to be well integrated and very seamless, touching around the employee lifecycle at large. About 39% of the organizations are considering the change in the need for future skills. What this means is that there will be more skills which will require a knowledge or proficiency of dealing with systems which will have artificial intelligence. So there are even newer roles which are getting created in organizations as an AI coach or an AI trainer, which will actually be training or coaching people to use AI systems within the organization and leverage it effectively. So clearly organizations are looking at forward at investing so much more money in developing the artificial intelligence capability within their organization. And what's really interesting and as well as frightening at the same time is that 63% of the organizations are also rethinking the role of their HR department. And probably which is why we are here today to talk about how HR is going to get impacted with the impact of artificial intelligence.
Yes, so that was my next question to you, that how do you think AI will impact the role of HR?
Well, it's a great question, but to answer this, I think, if I have to answer it very simply, I can answer it as a yes or a no, but I think we will not do justice unless we look deeper at the at each of these domains independently. And which is where I think it is important to understand what artificial intelligence is, and it is important to understand HR in isolation as well before we understand how both of them will be tied together. Artificial intelligence, as most of you may know, is mostly enabling the machines to be able to perform the tasks, activities, or functions of a human being. And how artificial intelligence is enabling us today, I think you would have observed how artificial intelligence is enabling us today through different forms and shapes. Right now, I call it as a phase of assisted technology or assisted intelligence. Take an example of a Netflix, which throws up top movies or movie picks for you, or LinkedIn articles, which picks LinkedIn articles based on your past behavior or past reading style. Or Facebook, which picks up articles, movies, or images which are relevant for you based on your past behavior on Facebook. And so that's assisted intelligence. Machines are helping us in guiding our thought process towards a particular direction. And so that's what we call as assisted intelligence. And we are playing somewhere between assisted intelligence as well as augmented intelligence. Now, what is augmented intelligence? I consider car ride sharing example as a classic example for augmented intelligence. Car ride sharing is mostly, if you look at the entire operation, a human would start the transaction to say that I need a cab. And I need a cab from a destination A to a destination B. And the machine would pick up the request and ask me a few questions, probably around the fare, around the time taken, around the kind of vehicle that I require. And then it will connect with the drivers. There is an intervention from the drivers where the driver reacts to the request that is received from the machine, rejects or approves the request, and then it comes back to the person who had booked it. So if you actually observe it, it is a beautiful interplay of how machines as well as human beings are working together to perform a task in a very simple, easy manner, as well as in a very short time. And the third phase of artificial intelligence that's going to come up is the autonomous intelligence, which you would have heard a lot about this already. And it is being talked at length today. Autonomous intelligence is your self-driving cars. That's the classic example that I can think of for autonomous intelligence. And as you know, self-driving cars are under a whole lot of surveillance and scrutiny because of the data ethics, data privacy and security issues that it can create. And so it's somewhere in the future. We don't know when it will happen, but it is somewhere in the future. And that would determine how a lot of things work for us, even at workplaces. But yes, that's how we are experiencing artificial intelligence. Like I said before, we are between assisted intelligence and augmented intelligence somewhere at this point of time. We are obviously experimenting with how we operate under the artificial intelligence further. I think going down deep into human resources independently, like I said, we will have to study human resources as a function before we really marry artificial intelligence and human resources together. If you go deep into human resources as a function, human resources has always existed on a continuum of being operational and strategic. While in a recruitment function, hiring a resource may seem like a very transactional task, but on the other side, there has been a whole lot of strategy that goes behind it. For example, which colleges do you hire from, or which schools do you go to for hiring your talent, or what skills do you require in your organization, what levels do you require these skills on, are some of the very strategic questions that HR has been answering along with the business. And so it has always been a combination of being operational and strategic across the function. Similarly, if you take an example of onboarding someone in the organization, while onboarding an individual can just remain to be an operational process, there is also the other continuum of it being, of it creating a wow experience for a candidate and it being used as a differentiator by organizations, right? So HR has always existed as, you know, on a continuum of being operational and strategic. And so if we apply artificial intelligence and HR together, if we combine these together, we could take another example of, you know, again, recruitment in this case. And if you look at the recruitment example again, and I know the slide is coming up. If you go to the recruitment example again, this particular diagram shows that the list of activities that a recruitment function does. And if you look at the x-axis reflects the potential for automation and how easily a task can be automated within an organization. And the y-axis reflects how much human touch is required or how much value gets added with a human touch in that particular task. For example, if you take an example of candidate screening or candidate matching, you know that a candidate matching can be done by technology. It can easily be done by technology today. It doesn't require as much of a human intervention. A typical task is, you know, looking at different resume and looking at a job description and seeing which resume fits the best as per the job description and eliminating those resume which do not fit as per the job description, right? So it's as simple as a task as that. And if you realize that the value that gets added by the human touch is very minimal in this example, right? So that's how some of these activities have been plotted in the graph. So candidate matching is clearly in the bottommost quadrant. And like they say, the bottommost quadrant will have the most potential for automation and will have more chances of it getting automated sooner than later within organizations. On the other side, you know, there are tasks, for example, you have to negotiate an offer with the candidate, you know, and or you have to sell the organization to the candidate so that the candidate really understands what is the contrast between an offer A and an offer B that may be available with the candidate. So that selling of the role or that selling of the candidate can be done only as an interactive procedure. And only if you understand the communication models, only if a system understands, you know, probably the biases, the background, the feelings or emotions that an individual would bring to the table. And right now that requires a whole lot of human touch. And the human touch can actually add value and even deflect the decision of an employee from making an offer or not taking an offer or not taking that offer. And so the automation potential is really low for a transaction like this. And so the bottommost quadrant is, you know, more transactional, easily automated or can be easily automated. The topmost quadrant is slightly more humane, requires more humane skills for you to do that. The value added from the human touch is significant and it will be hard for us to translate it into machines. And so this graph clearly reflects around how artificial intelligence, if it is applied to a human resource context, can really change the context of how it is applied within the organizations.
Mm-hmm. All right. Supriya, can you please elaborate, like, what are the competencies and skills in HR that will stay relevant even after AI?
Well, in the words of Josh Burson, I think what's very interesting to note is that Josh Burson has taken an analogy to the full stack software engineer and applied the same to an HR professional. And in the world of software developers or software engineers, a full stack developer is someone who is magical. And I say magical because the individual should be actually knowing the hardware, the operating systems, the database, applications, user interface, design, and mobile applications to be called a full stack engineer, which means that an individual, in short, should know the 360 degree of the operation of a particular machine, and which is quite hard. It is quite an intensive, quite an comprehensive machine. And for anyone to know that, you know, it's quite hard. And today, the expectation from an HR professional is going to be to become a full stack HR professional. For years, we have existed in silos as being only recruitment professionals or only L&D professionals or only HR business partners. I still call HR business partners as still slightly more generalist than specialist. Mm-hmm. But we've still existed in silos, you know, in the HR function. And I think the demand for HR professionals will be to become the full stack HR professionals with the ability to be able to not only bring the HR domain expertise to the table, but also bring in consulting skills or problem solving skills or listening skills to the table to be able to understand a client's problem, to be able to understand the client's business context and the context of the industry. It's not just as simple as business acumen. It's actually understanding how the customer is operating in a particular work environment or a business environment or an industry environment. And it will be very integral for any HR professional to consult and provide a solution to a client working in a particular industry. For example, we all know that the solutions that apply to a manufacturing industry are not the same as the solutions that apply to an information technology industry. Or the solutions are not the same for a media or a communication industry. They are significantly different from each other. The workforces are significantly different. And so for an HR professional, it will be very important for the HR professional to understand the business acumen and industry experience. It will be important for the HR professional to understand the technology, the data, tools, and vendors which are available in the market to be able to provide the right solution to their customers. And it's also important for them to understand what is leadership and how to lead others to be able to preach it to others around leadership or around executive presence or any of the other proposals or solutions that you are taking to the leaders. So I think some of these competencies around consulting, problem solving, business acumen, industry experience are going to be relevant. And the skills that come to my mind are skills like emotional intelligence, empathy, creativity, innovation, which I call them as more humane skills as well, will be so much more important for HR professionals to have and to be able to differentiate themselves from not only other HR peers, but also robots, as well as the artificial intelligence that will be integrated with their tools.
So this brings me to my next question, and that's what we are to discuss today. So, Supriya, do you think that technology can ever replace HR professionals?
Well, I call this as an esoteric question. It's philosophical, it's cryptic, it's mystical, and I don't think that there can be a straight answer to this question. I would like to go back to the same principles of artificial intelligence and apply them in HR. And if you look at it today, like I said, we are probably in the phase of assisted intelligence within the organizations where we have started having chatbots, we have started having more integrated, more intelligent recruitment software. We have started having more systems around learning and development where probably we have portals which pick top learning and development programs for employees. But we are in a very assisted intelligence phase at this point of time. We need to emerge. We need to move to the augmented intelligence phase. We need to go to a phase where man and machines will be taking decisions and leveraging each other for the right skills and for creating more effectiveness within the organization. But we are yet to reach the autonomous intelligence phase. And I think it will take time for people to reach to autonomous intelligence space. And like I said, there are security and data ethics and data breach issues associated with it. So I think till the time that we reach the autonomous intelligence space, I would like to say that HR professionals will decide if technology can replace HR function or not. Now, going back to the recruitment example, if you continue to do tasks which are low on human touch and are repetitive, mundane, and can be easily automated, then clearly HR functions will get wiped off and HR functions will get replaced by machines because those are the tasks that the humans are performing anyway. But if you want to add value and if you want to create that differentiation for your organization and you make your organization profitable as well as competitive in the industry, it will be important for HR professionals to emphasize on skills that add value from the human touch. Over the years, we've hated doing tasks around employee engagement or really engaging with employees and counseling or coaching them through their challenges at workplace or coaching leaders and top management in making effective decisions for their organizations. We've really stayed away and we've sat on the edge and mostly operated using our systems and doing mostly operational tasks around giving rewards or probably completing performance appraisals or probably more process related tasks. But now we will have to move into tasks which will require us to have a very clear knowledge of how organizations are moving in the future and to be able to enable them to move into the future. And if as HR function, we are doing some of those tasks that are enabling organizations to move towards the future, HR function will remain irreplaceable. I think my two cents on this topic, I know it's a very esoteric question, and there could be a simple answer as a yes or a no, but if you look at it, HR will be able to add that competitive advantage to the function. HR professionals will be able to do so. And if they are failing to do so, then the HR function will definitely be easily replaceable by machines.
That's an interesting, take off point of view on a particular topic. So Supriya, is there any recommendation from your side for an HR technology platform that can enable HR professionals to engage and retain their employees more effectively, and like an AI platform that can work hand in hand with HRs?
Yes, so well, I've been an HR professional for most part of my career and I have experienced most of the systems across 4 or 5 different organizations that you called out earlier. And in my experience, what I've realized is that Xoxoday as a platform definitely is an integrated suite of products which engage employees, recognize employees, and allows employees to collaborate with each other all in one pocket, all through one platform, which ensures the employees to have a seamless integrated experience, makes their usage of the systems very easy. And also it's an interactive platform, easy to use platform, which allows, individuals to jump onto the platform and start using it right from day one. So I really recommend Xoxoday as one of the platforms that that can be leveraged for employee recognition, employee engagement, and employee collaboration. And Xoxoday as an organization has a great history as well. It has been in existence for about 7 years. It has clients across the world, 500 plus clients, present across 7 locations in the world. Large organization, very well recognized in the industry for the technology and the data security practices that it brings to the table. So as an HR professional, I also feel very comfortable and confident in storing my data on Xoxoday as a platform and while also leveraging it as an integrated platform which enables world-class employee experience and also enables employee engagement, recognition, and collaboration at the same time in one platform. So I think I would recommend Xoxoday Pulse as one of the platforms for employee engagement, recognition, and motivation.
Okay. So I would like to ask our participants here if they have any questions, so they have any doubts regarding the role of AI in HR or what they can do to overcome it. Okay, so Supriya, I do have another question for you. I just want to know, what's your fantasy on artificial intelligence at workplace?
Wow, that's interesting. Well, I think I would be really happy to have a robot writing my performance appraisal on my behalf on the systems and also getting me the best performance appraisal ratings. So I would look forward to the day when a robot could do that for me.
But don't you think that would, you know, obviously, as you said in the previous slide, that the emotional factor that is involved in such practices, a robot would not be able to do that?
Well, I guess we will have to go to the augmented intelligence phase where it will have to be done in integration between a man and a machine. If the machine could start writing it and I could just add my differentiation through emotional intelligence and other softer skills, I think it's a win-win for me as an employee.
Okay, so we have a question from Reshmi. Reshmi is asking, how can AI influence the decision-making?
Sorry, could you just repeat that?
Reshmi is asking, how can AI influence the decision making?
So yes, artificial intelligence, what artificial intelligence will do to systems is that artificial intelligence will bring in data points that are relevant for decision making. For example, if in the earlier world, if there was an analysis of attrition that had to be done, mostly an HR professional would look at collating data from various systems and putting that in one place and then, you know, applying some Excel skills and applying their own HR expertise and driving conclusions or inferences or qualitatives and making decisions based on the analysis done by an individual. Now, what artificial intelligence would do is artificial intelligence would make the systems so much more integrated and so much more interactive that a whole lot of data will come in place together. It will also probably suggest things like, you know, things from the data. For example, if there are 50% of employees who are leaving because of compensation, and if there are any exit data points that are also additionally available, you know, in the system itself will help, you know, draw inferences around how an employee can be retained within an organization, right? So that's the piece that artificial intelligence is reducing from the job of an HR professional and adding it on into a system, and then enabling HR folks to take that decision. For example, then an HR person can actually go into a deeper analysis around understanding whether the system, what system is proposing, is the right solution to the problem or not. Or is there another reason, for example, manager was not managing the team very effectively? Was there something around that? Can that be a possibility of a reason for exit or not? That integration of man and machine will happen and we will move into that augmented intelligence phase. And once that happens, the entire process of analysis, which in the earlier days may have taken sometimes even a day or sometimes even a week, that will get reduced to a couple of hours or even less than that.
Mm-hmm. I hope, Reshmi, your question was answered. Okay. So Supriya, how soon do you think that AI will start actually impacting the HR roles that are going on right now?
I think artificial intelligence has already started impacting our lives. You know, for example, I said that candidate screenings have already moved into artificial intelligence platforms. Or onboarding processes have already become so much more interactive and so much more automated today. So I think it's already started happening. For probably an augmented intelligence state to evolve and appear will take probably 5 to 10 years, and that too depending on the receptivity of the organization. I think autonomous intelligence is probably far ahead of us. I would think that would take probably more than 10 plus years. Like I said, there are many more questions that need to be resolved. In fact, I've also written a paper on ethics in artificial intelligence and how that's going to shape the organizations differently today. And if you look at that, I think the organizations are right now in very nascent stages to even resolve what ethics mean for them in the context of artificial intelligence. And I think it will be important for HR professionals to play a very important role in arriving at what are those ethics which will be really important for the organizations and integrate them into the software that we are going to use. So that, we are well prepared when we reach the stage of autonomous intelligence, even if machines are replacing us, we know that we are in, that the employees or the workforce or the organizations are going to be in safe hands and are not going to cause irreplaceable damage to the organization.
Perfect. All right, Supriya, I think that's it from my side today. I would like the audience to see if they have any questions from their side. And if not, then we can close this thing. And thanks a lot, Supriya, for such an insightful session today. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I hope you did too.
Yes, it was a pleasure. And yes, if there are no more questions, we'll call it a day. Thank you, everyone, for joining this session. We hope that we've been able to answer some of your emotions or apprehensions around the topic. It's an interesting topic, and we hope we've been able to resolve some of your emotions, apprehensions, or curiosity around this.
Thank you, Supriya. And yeah, we'll be sending you the copy of the webinar and recording and the PPT as well over the mail in some time.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Sharma.
Thank you, Supriya. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.